Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Bulfatih. His Royal Highness Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa remotely received the 12th finalists of the government innovation competition Fikra. He stressed the importance of even greater public sector competitiveness to drive innovation, enhance productivity and efficiency, and support the kingdom's comprehensive development led by His Majesty the King. His Royal Highness highlighted that the innovative projects presented within the first and second editions of Fikra have already provided impressive solutions to various challenges within the government, further enhancing public sector efficiency even during the unprecedented challenges of the global COVID-19 pandemic. He then congratulated the three winning concepts from this year's edition, praising each for encapsulating national responsibility and ensuring the public sector continues to serve and benefit the kingdom and its citizens. His Royal Highness went on to note the importance of further strengthening public sector efficiency by implementing the winning projects in line with the government's programs and priorities. The winners presented their creative ideas before the members of the Government Executive Committee, chaired by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister. The winning entrants expressed their pride in the success of this year's Fikra, a competition launched by directives of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister. The competition winners praised His Royal Highness's continued support for those working in the public sector and commitment to promoting creativity and innovation across government in line within the kingdom's aspirations. Following a multi-tiered evaluation process, 12 concepts qualified for the final stages of the competition. These ideas were presented to an evaluation committee of a number of ministers and were the subject of a public vote. The three winning concepts are the expansion of the physiatric health services within the community presented by Buthain Al-Asfour and Dr. Ali Salman of the Physiatric Hospital at the Ministry of Health, the inclusion of first aid basics in school curricula presented by Kauthar Fuad Salman and Nadia Jassim Abu Dries, also from the Ministry of Health, and expanding the housing land bid programs presented by Sayyid Mahmoud Adnan Al-Biladi of Bahrain's Labour Fund, Tamkeen. The first Deputy President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of the Bahrain Olympic Committee, Zainab Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, met with the President of the Bahrain National Paralympic Committee, the NPC, Sheikh Mohammed bin Daij Al Khalifa. Zainab Sheikh Khalid praised the efforts of Sheikh Mohammed bin Daij in implementing plans and programs to develop sports for people with special needs to make further achievements in continental and international participations. His Highness was briefed on the plan for the new year, which includes the participation of national teams and the organization and procedures taken by the committee to host and organize the Asian Para Games for Youth from the 1st to the 10th of December 2021, wishing him success. For his part, Sheikh Mohammed bin Daij hailed the outstanding role of His Highness Sheikh Khalid in supporting sports, especially sports for people with special needs, through the programs and initiatives launched by His Highness. He stressed that the National Paralympic Committee seeks to develop this sport to advanced levels to strengthen Bahrain's position in the Paralympic movement globally. The first Deputy President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of Bahrain Olympic Committee, Zainab Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, received at his office in Al Wadi Palace the President of the Bahraini Handball Association, BHA, Ali Isa Ishaqi. Zainab Sheikh Khalid praised the BHA's outstanding efforts in implementing development programs that contribute to boosting the status of the games and elevating the skills and efficiency of the players. His Highness was briefed by Ishaqi on the latest preparations by the senior national handball team for the 2021 International Handball Federation, the IHF, World Men's Handball Championship in Egypt in January, and for the 2021 Tokyo Olympic Games in June 2021. He expressed pride in the great performance of the handball national team. He added that the team has demonstrated advanced levels in all the championships by achieving outstanding results that boosted the reputation of Bahraini sports. He praised the efforts exerted by His Highness Sheikh Khalid to develop sports, including handball, in Bahrain. He lauded his generous support to BHA to carry out its plans to achieve more successes and to prepare for the World Championships and the Olympics. The Council of Representatives held its weekly session presided over by its Speaker Fawzia Zainal. The session discussed and approved Decree Law No. 22 of 2020 to include emergency expenditures in the state's general budget for the fiscal year 2020, Decree Law No. 27 of 2020, amending some provisions of Decree Law No. 15 of 1977 to issue development bonds, and Decree Law No. 28 of 2020, amending some provisions of the Commercial Companies Law, and referred them to the Shura Council. The meeting also approved a draft law adding a new paragraph to Article 32 of the Labour Law and the Private Sector and referred it to the Shura Council. The Minister of Interior General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa today visited the Muharraq Police Directorate, where he was received by the Chief of Public Security, Major General Tariq Hassan Al Hassan, and the Governor of Muharraq, Salman bin Hiddi Al Manna'i. The Minister conveyed the greetings of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa to the officers and affiliates of the Muharraq Police Directorate and to the people of Muharraq. He also conveyed the thanks and greetings of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, to the people of Muharraq and to the Police Directorate. The Interior Minister valued the interest and the follow-up of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister of the Bahraini fishermen and their compensation. He stated that the Coast Guard continues to receive fishermen to record the damages as a result of the maritime terrorism they were subjected to. The Interior Minister then extended thanks to the Governor of Muharraq for his efforts and his speech, which reflected the noble patriotic sentiments of the people of Muharraq.
بداية ودي أني أنقل لكم تحيات سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه، وإلى جميع أهالي محافظة المحرق اللي يكن لهم جلالته كل المحبة والتقدير والاعتزاز. أيضا يشرفني أني أنقل لكم شكر وتقدير سيدي صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد رئيس الوزراء. وقبل ما أتكلم عن موضوع المحافظة، أيضا ودي أن أثمن غاليا اهتمام سموه الكريم ومتابعة الشخصية لموضوع الصيادين. الصيادين لا زالت خفر السواحل تستقبلهم لحصر الأضرار اللي حدثت عليهم من جراء ما تعرضوا له من إرهاب بحري، وكان سبب واضح في التأثير على معيشتهم وعلى عائلاتهم. بالنسبة للأخ سلمان، طبعا يسعدني أن أنا أشيد بدورك في المحافظة والعمل اللي تقوم فيه بشكل دائم. أي نعم، جزاك الله خير. ولكن ودي أؤكد على الكلمة الصادقة اللي جاءت معبرة عن المشاعر الوطنية لأهل المحرق. وأنت ما قصرت، نقلت لي يعني استغراب واستنكار أهالي المحافظة من رجال من عائلات المعلومات المسيئة اللي بثتها قناة الجزيرة حول ممارسات غير قانونية من قبل مديرية أمن المحرق. ومع الأسف أن هاي الافتراءات الإخبارية من رددها نواب بريطاني. وأنا اليوم ودي أن يا أخ سلمان أن أتأكد لأهالي المحافظة أن مديريتهم الأمنية ما كانت مركز للتعذيب لا هي ولا غيرها أو لسوء المعاملة، لكن العكس هو الصحيح. لكم، وهذا الكلام اللي ودي توصل له المحرق، لكم أن أنتم يعني تفتخرون بمستوى يعني الأداء والإنجاز الأمني المتحقق في هذه المديرية. وحتى يكون الكلام أدق، فاليوم محافظة المحرق هي أقل المحافظات من حيث معدل الجريمة، وأنها يعني أشوفها فرصة أني أشكر يعني المدير العام وأيضا رؤساء المراكز وجميع الضباط والأفراد العاملين في معيتكم على يعني ما قدمتوه وتقومون فيه من عمل من أجل حفظ الأمن. شيء يجب أن نتوقف عنده هو ما تميزت فيه هذه المديرية من برامج شرطية مميزة اللي جعلتنا يعني نراقبها ونعمل على تطويرها. وأهم ما يمكن أن أشير له مركز حماية الأسرة وانعكاسها على العديد من يعني الأسر والأمهات والأبناء، وهذه مشروع رائد ويجب أن نحافظ عليه ونطوره في باقي المديريات. وهذا الكلام حق رئيس الأمن العام. وأيضا شرطة المجتمع وتنظيمها وعملها في محافظة المحرق في الواقع تميزت بأداء وفيه تفاعل وتجاوب من قبل الجمهور، وهذا يعني أنجح المشروع وجاء ضمن المفهوم المجتمعي اللي من أجله أنشئت شرطة المجتمع. ولابد أن احنا هني نشكر أيضا المدير عام السابق اللي هو العميد فواز الحسن، لأن كانت له بصمته في هذه البرامج المتميزة. نظرا ل يعني تفوق وتميز هذه البرامج، يعني الأمر جعلنا نعرض هذه التجربة على ضيوفنا الأمنيين المهتمين بتطوير الأداء الشرطي، لأن الموضوع اليوم أصبح شأن يمس أمن محرق. فليكن معلوم بأن ما يمس المحرق بأي شكل من الأشكال فإنه تعرض لنا جميع. فالمحرق هي الأصل، واللي ما عنده غيرة على أصله ما في خير. وأنا شخصيا مشمول بكل ما يمس المحرق، لأني أنا ابن المحرك الواقع. لو جيت بأتكلم وأبي أوصف يمكن أقول أن محافظة المحرق هي يعني القلب النابض بالهوية الوطنية البحرينية، وفي الواقع أنها اكتسبت يعني هذه الهوية من جذور تاريخها. و اللي تأسس واستقر في نفوس الناس وفي قلوبها، وإحنا اليوم نمثل يعني امتداد لكفاح الرجال والأبطال اللي ضحوا من أجل أن يحمون أهلهم ويحمون أمنهم ويدافعون عن مكتسباتهم. وهاي الكلام لكم ولإخوانكم جميع. فبهاي الروح لازم أن احنا نؤدي عملنا بهذه الروح المخلصة، يجب أن نعمل. يعني هذه ملخص الكلام اللي وددت أني أنا أوصل لك، وإلا فأني أسأل الله أن شاء الله يوفقنا معاكم إلى خدمة جلالة الملك وخدمة البحرين، وأن يعيننا على حمل مسؤولية الأمن، ونسأل الله التوفيق.
The Southern Governor, His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Ali Al Khalifa, expressed the thanks and appreciation of the people of the Southern Governorate to His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, stressing their pride in His Majesty's keenness to provide a decent life for citizens and secure their livelihoods. They also commended the Cabinet's rejection during yesterday's meeting, headed by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, of any offensive actions against citizens, and that necessary measures will be taken to preserve their rights sites. The governor conveyed the appreciation of the people of the Southern Governorate of the efforts to support Bahraini fishermen and the Ministry of Interior's procedures to assess the damages to compensate them as a result of the procedures taken by the Qatari authorities. His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Ali expressed their people of the governorate's rejection and condemnation of the false allegations broadcasted by Al Jazeera channel regarding Muharraq's police directorate, affirming that Muharraq has a long-standing Arab and Islamic heritage and that its people are a symbol of patriotism. He added that these lies are a reflection of the incitement approach which this channel is accustomed to and cannot harm the kingdom's security system. His Highness pointed out that the people of Qatar should not tolerate the fabrications of this misleading channel, which spreads sedition and harms relations between the two people. He indicated that the Muharraq Police Department is an integrated model in security performance and appreciated by everyone through its professional security services, which is part of the security system at the Ministry of Interior, which operates under the directives of the Minister of Interior, General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, within the framework of his keenness to maintain security, protect public safety, and achieve comprehensive security through constructive community partnership. His Highness praised these national stances, noting that Bahrain is a model of coexistence, communication, and good neighborliness, which is the approach consolidated by His Majesty the King and followed by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister. His Highness indicated that the governorate continues to communicate with citizens through the designated platforms and field visits within the framework of activating community partnership and improving the provided services. The Ministry of Health said today that the number of coronavirus cases reached 1,941 with 187 recoveries and 202 registered new cases. 99 of the new registered cases are expatriates, 84 are contact of active cases, and 19 are travel-related. The Ministry urges everyone to comply with the guidelines issued by the National Task Force for Combating the Coronavirus.